Good afternoon. Welcome to the live stream on how to use a payroll reconciliation worksheet for W-2s and how to use the SAGE reports that go along with the worksheet. So today's class, we're going to be talking about, we're going to go through an Excel file that goes through what you should do prior to issuing your W-2s for the year. So that you don't have any tax, IRS, or state agencies sending you any notices because your records don't agree. So that's kind of the purpose of this class. So we're going to use a couple of reports in payroll. There's also another tool that we use that Banger has generated that will help reconcile the payroll tax returns in your general ledger and such. I'm going to be using SAGE reports in this live stream, but I'm also going to attach this payroll tool that we have created that you can use throughout the year to help pull down data from SAGE into Excel. Okay, we're going to focus on reports on this one. So when you file your tax returns for your different taxes for payroll throughout the year, you have your 941s, your state unemployment, your FUTA, and then at year end, you file your W-2s. You might have to file like a state annual withholding return. And all of that needs to be, or should be, reconciled before you issue your W-2s as a best practice. It is actually required in the W-2 instructions for you to reconcile at the bare minimum your 941s to the W-2s. Okay, so I'll show all that. So the reports that that I use to reconcile this for the year, I pull down the subject to by date range report. So if you're not using the Excel tool that we've given out in another live stream, the Excel file that makes this a little bit easier, you use this subject to date range report if you want to pull info right out of SAGE. Okay. The other report that we're going to be working with is the 941 preparation report. Okay. So using the sample company here, date ranged it for the year for our, to get our gross pay. So when we're looking at our SUTA returns, our state unemployment returns, and our federal unemployment returns, gross pay is reported on those. So in order to tie out to your SAGE gross pay, this report is has the gross pay amounts on it. Okay, so we're going to be working with this one, and we're going to be working with the 941 preparation report that lists out each payroll, and you want to make sure it's by check date, because that's how 941s work, and you're going to want to, and it totals it by month, as you can see, but this will give you your federal 941 taxable wages, your Social Security subject to, as you can see, Medicare and the various tax columns, okay, to help you if you were preparing, you know, your 941 manually, not using the Aatrix wizard in here, then you could use this report to fill out your 941, okay, so before they had any of that. So what I like to do is pull up the 941 prep report for the whole year and look at federal taxable wages column, make sure that agrees to my the summary of my 941s that I actually filed. Okay, so we'll go through the whole process, but that's the general gist of what I'm going to be showing for payroll reports in here to reconcile at the end of the year. Okay, so we're also going to be looking at this example spreadsheet that helps you tie out your different tax returns and tie out your general ledger totals as well. So this is a pretty simple payroll company and very simple payroll setup, an example I'm showing, but you might have like pre-tax health, you know, dependent care, various things happening over here, or more deductions and such. But for what I'm showing, this is going to be on a very simple level. Okay. So let's go over here. So first, let's look here at our subject two report. Okay, so I'm going to scroll down to the bottom and gross wages are $366,000. So over here, that's what this comment means. So gross wages on this Excel file comes from that report. Okay, so you can date range it by quarter and get quarterly amounts, but you want to make sure on your SUTA return that your first quarter gross wages equal the SAGE subject to date range report for that quarter, for each quarter here. Okay, now Aatrix also does the filing for you if you use the wizard here for your state unemployment returns. But if you're going to the website and uploading a file or typing in the wages, then it'll calculate the taxable wages for you. So on here, I just pull up my state unemployment returns and I'll type in my, you know, various taxable wage amounts that it generated. And then the tax also, depending on your rate, I'm using 1.5 just as an example, depending on your rate, you would have that calc over here. Okay. Now, I always like to tie out my my general ledger to my tax returns as well in my gross wages. So down here, I want to go to my state unemployment general ledger account in GL over here in the general ledger module, and I check that, you know, the related account equals what my SUTA return would show. Okay, if you're setting up this way. So this would be like, you know, my state unemployment tax goes to one account, FUTA, FICA, and labor go to these specific accounts, right? So so they say they agree. Okay, that's a good check on my state unemployment return. So the other one that uses gross wages more than taxable wages is a FUTA return. So I would pull up my federal unemployment tax return for the entire year that I filed and or are getting ready to file, right? So because you want to do this ahead of time and check all this. And my gross wages should equal what my gross wages equal per the subject to date range report. So on my 940, over here, usually that is your gross wages. And then you have the amounts that are paid over $7,000 per person down here. And then your tax, your taxable wages and your FUTA. So this box 3, box 7 and box 8 would be right here. Okay. So you want to make sure that all ties out before you file. With your, and then also too, you can see, you know, I matched up the FUTA to my expense account on the general ledger. Okay. So, for gross wages, that one is, a pretty decent report to use. There are other reports and other, like I said, that payroll tool, which I'll attach to this live stream again. It's been in another one. That one can be used as well to get a lot of this information, and it's all in one spot. So, okay. So let's say we want to check the 941s. So those are a little more information to fill out. So, I like to pull out the 941s that are that I have actually filed and fill out this Excel file using that. So I pull out my first quarter and I type in my federal wages from box or line two. Okay, so I put the corresponding line on the 941 preparation report up here, so you know which ones to type in. Okay, and this tool will be provided on the live stream after it's over. Okay, so you fill out all of your quarters and you type in all your amounts. And you get to a certain total right here. And that is what should, so you can see there's a formula here. These should agree to what your W-2 totals should be at the end of the day. Okay, so your federal taxable wages in, on line two of your four 941s you file should equal what you put in box one on your W-2. So this is where the IRS will send you a notice if this stuff doesn't agree, because the 941s are a federal form. This is also a federal form, that, and they'll ask you, why don't these agree? So you want to make sure you do at the minimum this top part to the W-2. Okay. Now on the 941 report, just as a quick tidbit, you report the entire Social Security tax, employer and employee portion, but on the W-2, you only report the actual amount withheld. So Social Security taxes on the 941 will be double what they should show on the W-2, and same with Medicare, okay? That's the case unless you run into additional Medicare tax, which I'm not covering in this live stream, but in general, it's half of the 941 totals, okay? So that's a good check. So the formula here takes that and divides it by two, okay, for both of these. Okay, and then on your W-2, your 401k withholding, if it's pre-tax, would go in one of these boxes in box 12. Okay, so I assumed the only box 12 item we had was 401k. So I said in box 12A on the W-2, $8,770 should be reported there. Okay. Your state wages generally should equal your federal wages. Very rarely do they differ. So that's a good check there. So there's a formula there for that. So on your W-2, if there's something different, then you'll, you know, want to research why it's calculating that differently. So I'll talk about that in a second. And then your state withholding in box 17 should match your state withholding returns. Okay. So every quarter, most states require you to file a state withholding return. So I pull those up, fill this in, and that those two should equal each other. Okay, now down here is the reconciliation of the general ledger. So you're going to have gross wages, really simple, again, set up one account it hits. So all my gross wages hit, and that was the total that when I pulled up general ledger, that's what it showed. My FICA taxes, and actually in the example, I need to add Medicare in there too. Just this is the employer portion of Social Security and Medicare. So it'd be one half of these two. Your FUTA, that's my FUTA account on the general ledger, and my SUTA right here. Okay, so the rest of these are deductions and don't hit the expense side. You know, you also could go into the state withholding general ledger account and make sure your payments equal your deductions. But as far as reconciling it to the income statement, you just do a quick check here. You can do a full reconciliation, you know, make sure you list some more out here. You know, my withholding was X and I paid Y for state withholding and for your 401k provider and things like that too. But just to give you a start, you know, a template, because each company is different. You know, you could expand this if you wanted to tie out a little bit more on the payment side. Okay. So let's say you're using the Aatrix wizard and something isn't populating incorrectly down here. Most of the time, let's say your state wages don't equal your federal wages, and they generally should. Then what has happened is somebody that set up the 401k pre-tax code for deduction did not check that box. So your federal wages get reduced by the pre-tax 401k, but your state wages don't. So that's a common mistake people make. So if that is incorrect, then need to go through. If you use the Aatrix wizard, it's easy to adjust it. But your boxes here generally are the same when you're pre-taxing deductions. Okay, so you want to make sure usually both of those are checked. And then another common W-2 issue is if you come in here and you don't add a new deduction or a new required box 12. So you want to make sure you do that. Okay. So what a lot of people do is fill this out, you know, use the formulas to help you double check. You know, if my 941s fell out, I fill out all this up here. This should be pretty much left alone so that when you run the Aatrix wizard in the federal e-filing reporting area, your totals, before you even push the button to finalize W-2s, the totals will show in the wizard for you, all of this actually. So you want to make sure it matches up to this before you run the whole process. Okay, so like I said, at the bare minimum, you want to reconcile 941s to W-2s. Okay, I'm going to post this Excel file out on the live stream. I'll also post that other payroll tool I was talking about. And if you run into any issues where you're not sure, you know, in general, you know, maybe a question on how of what I'm talking about, or how Sage works, or you can't get a number to agree, or you have some sort of reconciliation issue, just reach out to us. You can reach out through the live stream. You can email help@bangerinc.com, and we will get back to you, you know, as soon as possible. There will be, you know, you'll get notices throughout the year, you know, from the IRS if you can't figure out how to fix it in Sage. You know, even though we're past the January filing deadline, you know, don't hesitate to reach out. Usually it's pretty fixable. You might have to amend something, but we can help you through that whole process and give you a little training on how this works in Sage a little more, so you can avoid future mistakes. So if you have any questions, again, reach out to help@bingert.com. Otherwise, we will see you on the next live stream. Thank you.